say?
The Minister of Defense. What you think?
You can say
leave it alone.
I'm gonna wait until we. I'm gonna bring it up, and however it go, it go.
See, you pick and choose,
I do.
Mr. Real.
No,
I don't.
Yes, you pick and choose.
On the gay
you
stuff. On the gay.
That's you pick and choose.
Yeah. Good. Yeah.
You pick and choose.
On homosexual.
You pick and choose.
Name something I pick and choose about.
You pick and choose a lot. Hold on. You do a lot stuttering like a DJ.
Name one. Name one situation I study.
We got the clips.
All right. Talk to me. Only thing I stutter about and I don't get in debt with is homosexuality.
That's picking and choosing. No matter how you drop it, that's pick and choosing.
Anything else?
You won't talk about Jay.
What is it to talk about Jay? He's fabulous. Ain't nothing wrong with him. He's lying.
All I said was,
he's
talking about
lying.
I'll pick and choose about battles with. I'm not talking about
Mom. You don't stay off of Jay. You don't stay off of 50. You don't stay off of 52?
Because I don't. I believe.
You only,
one day I might be beside these niggas. I'm going to get knocked
out.
All right.
So you picking and choosing.
Hold up. We just talked about 50 today, and I said I ain't going to touch it. In the past on this podcast,
so
I never picked and
choosing.
We pick and choose.
If you say you're not talking about
this, we ready? We ready?
We been ready.
All right, let's go.
Go
ahead, Trees.
Agree or Disagree podcast, episode 8. Let's get it in.
Bobbie Holliday.
Yes, sir. Bobbie Holliday.
Mike Anderson, M.
Mike Anderson. Yes, sir. I guess we start off with 50 Cent.
How you doing, bro? What's your name? Why you be
Tracy?
This the second week in a row.
Yeah, no, it's not. But anyway.
You didn't say your name? Never mind. Go ahead. Trey Deuce.
Yes, sir. 50 Cent. How this man only talks.
Wow. This
50
man.
Cent airs out G Unit.
50 Cent aired out G Unit this week. He said that, like, you know, in other words, I passed him the rock. And every time it go out of bounds, meaning they not doing nothing with their life. You know, I believe he spoon-fed them. I believe he spoiled them, spoon-fed them, and they got used to it and never reached out.
I kind of think all of them dudes can say that, though. Like, Jace can say that about State Property. Spoon-fed them, too, and they ain't never do nothing with it.
What, he spoon-fed them for 3 years?
I think, as long as they was under him. I think what 50's saying is more so, like, he gave them the oop.
Excuse me. Like, 1 minute.
So, Jay ain't give State Property the oop?
Listen,
I'm talking about, like,
Jay ain't do nothing for them. Damon Dash looked out more than Jay-Z could ever looked out.
That ain't what
anybody.
I heard Bean say, but
nah,
I'm just
that
saying.
That ain't what you heard Bean say.
Yeah. Nah.
It's not what I heard Bean say.
Nah.
But I'm just saying, so you can talk about that. What I'm saying is I want to stick on this. The 50 day, right?
Y'all got attitudes. Go ahead.
I'm just saying, the 50 Cent thing, though, what I think he's talking about more so, like, he gave a oop. And mm-hmm. They didn't take it and do what they supposed to, because he did more than what other CEOs or rappers did with their artists. You know what I mean? Like, Jay didn't really get on.
Yeah, he wasn't in the field with
them.
Yeah,
like 50
was in the field with him.
Like, well, I don't know in the field, but like he didn't push their records. Like, I ain't see Jay didn't get on everybody's records. You know what I'm saying? 50 really got on each one of their records and tried to, like, you know what I mean, gave them the oop. He gave them a head start. And that goes to show, a lot of money. So that goes to show you, like, it ain't no right or wrong way to do it, right? Like, as far as we got an artist, because the knock on Jay was he never did that for his artist. Remember they kept saying, but Jay looked at it like, well, it's better for you to go get it on your own. You know what I mean? Because then if I do give you the head start, now y'all going to blame me for that too. You know what I mean? So I look at 50-50 like, yo, I gave y'all the head start and y'all ain't do nothing. And then they blaming him.
Yeah, he's saying at least they should be on tour doing something.
He did the G-Unit album. He did... Yeah. He got on each one of their projects. He pushed them, man.
I think he really, really looked out for them big time. Y'all recall that he was giving them money a month just to wear G-Unit clothing. And he said, he called a meeting. He said, I know these niggas ain't going to have it on, so it'd be fine time to cut them. Yeah, the Reebok too. He was like, yeah, we gonna cut y'all from giving y'all that monthly fee, and they like, why? Look down at your feet. He said, look down at your feet.
The deal with Reebok. Remember they had the deal with Reebok.
Yeah. You're not wearing the stuff.
They wasn't wearing
it.
Yeah.
Y'all for it. So
they wasn't wearing.
I think he did a lot for them guys. You know, so. Like you say, you damn if you do, you damn if you don't.
That's why I never. That's why when I hear these artists, man, when they talk about like the artists that put them on, and they complain about what they didn't do, and it's like, ain't nobody. You gotta go out and get it your own anyway. So somebody always looking for somebody to blame for their failures. You know what I mean? Yeah.
Is that what Siegel did? You said.
Well, I mean, like, all right. I seen the story.
Excuse me, sir. We need him to answer this one.
Hold up. I seen the story. Petey Crack.
Love Petey Crack.
He was living in like an apartment or something, whatever. These dudes wanted to rob him. First person he called was Jay. Jay, like, yo, why are you calling me? Like, don't call me. Call the cops. Call somebody else. Like, what are you calling me
that's
for?
That's cruel.
Like, but what are they calling
But Jay probably like, what is Jay supposed to do?
He in New York. You in Philly. Like, what am I supposed to do?
What are you supposed to do?
Like, sometimes...
Jay's supposed to get on the I-95 with the goons and shit. Like,
that's the
like,
same thing we talked about Bow Wow, how you just waste your opportunity, you waste your money. It's like, nigga, what is you doing renting out an apartment anyway? Like, you supposed to be, you know what I mean? Farther than, I think it was, he was living on Spring Garden. You too accessible. You walking around with a $20,000 diamond chain. Mm-hmm. They seen you go up in there, and they trying to go up and get it. You shouldn't be there, in other words. Why are you calling me? I put you in a position to exceed. So the same thing, you know?
Right.
I like Petey Crack, though.
Yeah, I do, too.
The humblest man you can never meet.
Like the Siegel, Siegel, same thing. But because I heard Siegel speak on it, he was talking more so like how Dane was stealing money from him, though.
Mm-hmm.
So he was
saying. No, he didn't say that, son.
No, yes, he did say that. Man, you saying no, he didn't say that. Yes, he did say that. Like, he did say that, man. You keep saying. They just played the interview. Yo, the interview is on. You can watch the interview with Charlamagne. On Charlamagne.
Uh-huh.
So you couldn't have watched it twice and then say he didn't say it.
This is what he said.
He said Dame Dash stole money from me, man. That's what
he said. The man went and brought pro kids.
That's not just it. That's not all he just said.
That's it.
No, it's not. No, it's not, man.
I didn't see it.
That ain't what he just said, man.
Beanie Siegel had a deal with pro kids for
state
property.
That's one of the things. Yeah, right.
Dame Dash went and brought pro kids. Beanie Siegel feel as though all these niggas always feeling though that they entitled. Like, why we couldn't go half on it? All
right, but I ain't talking about that part. You right on that part. But he also said though that he found out that it was Dame Dash was taking millions of dollars on him. He said that he could have sued Dame Dash for embezzlement. This is what he said.
Wow.
Remember, this is what he said. The infamous Oskino video.
Right.
At the video.
And listen, this is not me making it up. You can go. This was an interview he did with Charlamagne when Charlamagne was working in Philly.
Mm-hmm.
This is because if you look on YouTube, they
say
Charlamagne.
I thought he just was going at Jay on that joint. He went at.
Well, no, it was. He kept it real on. So if you go on YouTube, y'all want to see the video. It's Charlamagne's last. It's why he got fired from Philly, some shit like that.
Mm-hmm.
And you listen to the whole interview.
Yeah.
And Dame, Beans really went more. He was more mad at Jay because of the he couldn't like reach out to him and shit like that. Mm-hmm. But he was talking about Dame Dash more financially.
But I feel as though he chose a side. I believe.
Well, he said
he did.
I'm talking about what he said.
It looked like.
At that time, it did look like it.
He was riding with Dame, and then when him and Dame fell out, he tried to call Jay.
Yeah, right.
You know?
Mm-hmm.
But I just wish I can just see him again on stage. Again.
Who?
You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Beanie Siegel and Jay-Z.
But they was on stage.
I know.
What's his name?
I know. Yeah.
That's probably all you going to get now.
Agree or disagree topic. Chris Brown. Comments about women of color.
So what was his comment?
Verbatim, I don't got it, but it was something.
We'll paraphrase. Yeah, we will paraphrase. What was his comment?
Dark skin women ain't his flavor. Like it ain't.
Oh, man.
It ain't
not attracted to dark.
Not attracted to dark skin women. Dark skin. I think he said something about big women too, but I know he said something about dark skin women.
Yeah, I ain't gonna get on even forward about that. You know what I mean?
Why? Cause that's how you feel.
No, that ain't how I feel. I'm gonna get on him about it. Cause that's his preference. But I'm just saying, like, So how do you feel about
people coming at him,
I think the reason they coming at him now is because something, all right, you say, but I think him saying it publicly is what's getting him in trouble.
Yeah.
Because we live in a time now, like, where, not even a time now, it's not even that you can't say nothing, but the way we getting treated and, like, our women getting treated now is, like, you looking at it as, like, the dark-skinned women or if you brand, like, yeah, their complexion matters. So now, him reinforcing the power that always already existed as far as, like, light-skinned women and dark-skinned women and then white women. You know what I'm saying? You don't want a black man to come out and say that publicly. You know what I mean? He can feel that. You know what I'm saying? And then, I mean, he can tell you with his homies, but, like, we all know you can't say everything publicly. And I think him saying it publicly, and he a powerful figure as far as a man that be around women, it makes him, you know what I mean, kind of like he stigmatized that too. You know what I mean? So,
how do you feel, brother?
Another person said that a while ago, like 3 years ago, and I was like, he a sucker. Like, blah, blah, blah. And something on the inside said, well, let's count the women you had. And I went down the line. I said, Zach, they was all light-skinned chicks and Puerto Rican and white. So, you know,
When I look at Serena Williams,
I don't get hyped. It's like three Serena Williams too.
It's like three little Kims.
Wow.
It's like three Serena Williams too. She on that LeBron juice.
So you saying she on steroids?
She on that LeBron juice. Shout out. She ain't always. I don't like how she look now. Now you talking about like 6-7 years ago? She was.
How do y'all feel women can do it openly though? Can speak about what they
like what,
and their preference, like.
But women emotional though, like that's like so. Women when they say stuff though, it's like you know what I mean. You hear it, but do it really affect you? You know what I'm saying? Like a woman,
watch it affect when he say it though.
Well, I think it matters because what men say affects what women do. What women do don't affect what men do. Like, see, that shit transferred to like the work world and everything. Majority, you know what I'm saying, is for men. That's why it's like when you hear it is whatever. But when it comes from like. Chris Brown is in a position of power from his side. You know what I mean?
Uh-huh. So he's gonna lose some change.
Yeah, no matter what Cardi B say, she's not in a position of power. She's managed by a man. You know what I'm saying?
A lot of her money come from women.
Right.
Women fans. So it
don't really matter.
That makes sense.
So that's probably why. But here's a deeper topic though, because y'all saying it right. So you think a lot of black men don't like black women?
You're absolutely right.
Yeah, I do.
A lot of black men are not attracted
to dark skin.
I do.
Where do this come from?
It comes from like you.
I don't think she light skin like that. Like.
And your last girl you had, she was light skin.
You don't know my last.
Your
girl.
Mother light skin. Yo, how you gonna tell you me? I seen old pictures.
No, you didn't. You don't know my last. And she wasn't light skin. Just by the way, so I'm saying you know that.
And you.
So no, don't try to skip. I just.
Oh, you want this?
Yeah. I be wanting to smoke. That's what I'm saying. Like, because you went there, so no, it wasn't. You know what I mean? I got a history. People will tell you, I ain't no discrimination on me.
Ain't no discrimination.
I had all shades besides white.
You like
so,
black
yeah, okay. I don't do white women, but I had all shades besides white.
So
you don't do white women at all?
No, I don't.
You don't find white women attractive
I can't. No, I'm just saying, that's me.
You saying you have dated dark-skinned women?
I don't have a brother. If you black and you built right, I'm cool.
You coming at you.
I'm cool.
Word. I was just joking. I never seen this girl from before. But
how do you feel about what he said?
You know,
but what's the reason
as
for
I,
it?
As
what do you think the reason
that's
for
that,
it? I think it's because
I believe
that's
the
all
magazines that our uncles and them had laying around
that's all
when we
seen.
Was little kids. You know what I mean?
TV, radio,
everything. It was never, you know, a colored woman, a black woman on TVs. You know, you notice all of them was light-skinned, you know? God bless you, Thelma.
You think it's
JJ sister.
You think it's all just because of that, though? Like, the TVs? Like, because I look at it, because it ain't just y'all. I got family members, and I look at them, and I think I'm the only one besides my other cousin that got, like, a black that's with somebody black. You know what I'm saying? And I'm looking at it like, so because I took psychology. You know what I mean? So I look at it like, could it be from like they moms, they aunts, or they grandma? That. But I'm saying though, do you get programmed to hate your mom? To hate? Because I look at it like this: when people don't like black women, is you saying to me that you don't like your mother? I look at it like that. Well, your aunt. So yeah. See, I grew up. I
can't
had
look
aunt.
At it like that.
I'm not. I mean, I might say it a little harsh, but it kind of goes.
That's what
like,
it is.
Yeah. Like my thing is like I don't like your own. I got beautiful like dark skinned cousins. Like they, you know what I'm saying? So that's probably why I never looked at it like ugly or nothing like that. They was all. I got a lot of aunts. I see my family. I got so many aunts. I got so many different shades. You know what I mean? So I never, you know what I mean? I didn't.
So that comment kind of disturbed you,
what?
Like a little bit. Chris Brown.
It disturbed me. I thought it take a man like for they can you choose what you want.
Cause it's actually a song. I think it's lyrics from a song.
Did y'all see the football players celebrating? They did a toast. No dark skinned kids.
See, now that's corny.
Yeah.
Now that's corny.
He's
right though. It did happen though. It did happen.
I didn't see.
And
it. I saw
that. A toast at a restaurant.
Yeah.
Saying, no dark skinned.
Yeah, I would have had an issue with that.
Yeah.
If I was there, I would have had an issue with that.
Two Redskin players, yeah.
Mm-hmm. For a team called the Redskins, go figure.
Yeah, go figure.
go figure.
Now, I think that is kind of more of a deeper problem because a lot of these like athletes, they come from the South. They come from the South, and like that's all they could be with is black women until they get money, and then pew.
But Kanye not
that's
from
a
the South.
Issue, huh?
Kanye not from the South. As soon as he got some money, he went right to the.
That's what he said. He leave your ass for a white girl.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
And the thing is, if you look at the NBA.
Yeah, but that's what I'm thinking. I'm talking about sports figures.
Yeah, but like, do you see Klay Thompson? He's black. Steph Curry. You see a lot of these players. There's a lot of. Mm-hmm. In other words, soon it will not be. A dark-skinned person, and 50 years from now, it's going to be
D-Wade got Gabby.
Klay Thompson.
Like,
LeBron.
You understand it's
going to
be a lot.
Not,
thank
like,
God.
But she's not like a darker woman. Like she,
no,
she,
I mean, but what I'm
she's
saying
dark
is,
enough.
Yeah,
she's
Tracy
dark
said
enough.
Like, Tracy said,
yeah.
Don't, I mean,
yeah,
but
I'm thinking dark.
That's
I'm talking
that,
about
that's
dark
that
women.
New money.
Yeah,
she's
but she darker than what
she's
we see.
Enough.
She darker than
she's
what we see.
She's Insta-like from Instagram.
Yeah,
but a lot of
I ain't never seen none of these dudes with a like black woman, like dark skin, like none of that.
Me and my wife was talking on the sofa. And we were saying, we was chilling on the sofa, and it's like, yo, these dudes, a lot of black men, a lot of white women, dating white women, give a lot of men leniency to do whatever they want. Like, you can come in the house whenever you want.
Exactly.
And I was like, it's according to, because the black, a white woman and a black woman are raised different. A lot of black women watch their mom being, abused, not mentally abused, and a black woman grow up saying, ain't no man going, don't let no man treat you this way. So white women watch their mother cater to
the father.
Have his food. And it's dangerous for a black man that's raised up in the ghetto because what happened? OJ. Okay.
Yeah.
You understand?
Yeah.
You watch a lot of these white of these black celebrities dating these white women, and what happened? Too much rope, and a lot of them choke themselves, go broke, and they get caught up with domestic dispute, violence.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Now, see,
you
get that's another thing too.
Yeah, because it's too much. You get to do whatever you want, and
until it get a little crazy.
Yeah.
But we talking about the women. What I'm saying is, what do you think is the men problem though when they grow up though? Like, why do they feel though that
it's
they
always
don't...
a fantasy? That it's like a fantasy.
Yeah, I think
island.
It's a fantasy. I think if you grow up not being able to touch that or go after that at all, but when you get money. And you can do whatever you want.
But do Puerto Rican? I don't know. So do Puerto Rican men be like? That's what I'm saying.
Puerto
so
Rican,
like
they kind of stick to their own.
That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm like. What's the fantasy? Like I just don't get it. Like I'm trying to
the hair.
To do what you want.
I don't think.
No,
I don't think
talking,
of a. I don't
that's,
think of.
That's different.
I'm not talking
about
white women. I'm talking about.
I took a little curve,
yeah,
but it's the hair. It's the skin. You understand?
And this, oh, you talking about the features?
No, no, yeah. I'm talking about what's the problem? Black men not to want black women. Like, what makes black men not to want black women?
I mean, as we was younger, look at what they portrayed on TV.
No, but I think it gotta be deeper than that, though.
I gotta be deeper than that. Being able to do whatever you want. That's
how I feel. But Spanish women not letting you do whatever you want.
No, not
Spanish women crazier than black women, man.
I'm talking about the fascination with another twist.
Oh no, no, we talking about like why we talking about why we like it can just be.
Why do black men hate their own?
As far as like they want light skinned women, they might not want the dark skin. I'm talking about why is it that we don't? I ain't talking about like white women specifically.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is black women will challenge a man, and a lot of black men don't want to be challenged. They just want to pay bills, sit and play their video games, and
but
not
isn't that
grow.
Being able to do what you want?
Oh yeah,
you keep going. All right, hold on. Thing is, I want to get back on the road.
I don't have the answer to it.
What you're saying? Why I don't have the answer.
I'm talking about
to
the sticking original point.
What you're saying? I don't have the answer.
Like we, because a black man, we were talking about shade. We wasn't talking about going completely to a different race.
Yeah, I'm attracted to
the lights. That's what I'm saying. Why do we grow up? Because you know what I mean. They ain't had nothing to do with white or nothing. You just light skin.
I took a curve.
Yeah,
I can't really say.
Yeah,
yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know. I can't really say why we be the infatuation with it.
It's hard telling the truth. Where did that come from with me? You know what I mean? All I did.
My cousins hated when I put them on blast.
I never dated a black woman.
My cousins hate me when I put them on blast for it. I be like, I ain't got we ain't got. Because my thing is like, where's I look at, I don't know, like I said, I take psychology and all that. I look at the bloodlines and how you leave it. Like,
do you have an answer?
So what? Yeah, but say, what do you?
I don't
think
have an answer. I'm just like, I do think it comes from growing up and you looking and
the woman we can never have in our mind.
I don't know if it's about the one we can't have, because like you said, you still be with a black woman, but then it might just be a light skinned woman, whatever. You know what I'm saying? Or whatever, this and that. I don't know if men grow up hate. I don't know. You know how we. Women was how we was raising kids and how they was raising men. Mm-hmm. That could be a resentment too. You know what I'm saying? Like, say if you was a boy, you just had a mom and she was just always, you know what I mean, on you or you know what I mean. That could be a resentment to that. I don't know. I don't have an answer to it, but I just know my cousins do hate me when I bring it up though, because I do bring it up. I'm like, you know what I mean? Like our bloodlines is not going. It's not. We ain't pure black no more. Like
I don't have. Ain't nothing like a sister. I can tell you that.
There ain't nothing like no. Yeah.
Yeah, I agree.
So it don't matter what shade it is. Me, I'm just going black. I ain't got no preference for it.
All right.
I'm not doing outside of black.
I'm not hating on Lil Wayne and Young Money featuring Drake. I wish I can every in the world. I was mad at that song as a Christian man. But then I thought about it and say, you know what? I'm a hypocrite.
You might be, bud.
Whoa! I mean, you know.
NBA frenzy. Free agency trades and signings. It's been a long 2 weeks.
I can't wait till they put a stop to it.
Put a stop to what?
To the super team theory, like. You know, it's not fun no more.
They did put a stop to it.
I think they put a stop to it.
They did put a stop to it. It's like 10 super teams now, man.
It's a lot of good teams now.
It's like five.
But that's enough. Before, you only had one.
You only had one.
Well, the Golden State Warriors. No, it was only one.
It was going to fall apart.
It was whoever Golden State Warriors was going to play. We knew that.
What happened to competing? Like, the NBA is just not the same.
No, I think it's back.
I love it, though.
I think it's back.
I love it.
I love what Kawhi did. Even though I don't like you. I love what he did.
I think it's more competitive than it's been in the last 10 years.
Kawhi pulled I don't even know what to call it.
What y'all think happened in that room when did Magic Johnson say something slick?
I told
like,
you,
just
man,
don't
listen,
trust these niggas.
I think Magic Johnson really is. We talk about this. I think he's sabotaging the Lakers, man. Because he knew to let nobody know that Kawhi wanted to talk to him, and he told everybody.
Kawhi said, I'm only meeting with bosses. You ain't allowed in the meeting. I was like, wow.
Right.
Yeah.
And
another thing I liked what he did, he didn't let them all come together. He had individual meetings with them, each one of them, because he wanted to hear what was the truth and what wasn't the truth. So, you know, other teams, he had everybody there with them. He had them separately. And then he put Magic in there, and then Magic ran his mouth.
No, I think Magic. I think
allegedly.
I think Magic is sabotaging leaguers. I don't think Magic went in and ran his mouth. I think.
I like Magic. Kudos.
I like Magic, too.
They did him dirty.
Yeah, he doing what, I mean, he playing the game. He like,
probably said, listen, you know, business is business. Basketball is basketball.
Basketball, right.
Genie bus foul, son.
Yeah.
And so is Palinka.
Yep.
Yeah, Palinka sound.
That's what I think.
Funny.
That's what I think he told him, because.
But you know what? He didn't meet with Palinka though. They said
no. But I'm saying
he didn't meet with him.
That's why I think Magic Johnson.
Bosses.
Magic Johnson. Yeah. And I
that
think
that was a shock, man.
Yeah, he didn't.
No, it wasn't our brothers either. It wasn't our brothers.
It wasn't her brothers. No. I know he didn't meet with Palinka.
No, he didn't. I think Magic told him exactly what it is.
Yeah,
you can't
shocked,
trust them motherfuckers over there.
Taking Paul George with him, even though Paul
George. That was a shocker, though, of the summer.
That was a shocker of the summer.
How that shit happened.
But Paul George ain't what he.
Ain't what?
I'm trying to figure out what
I give him when I give him a six, as in being great. A six. A six.
I'm not mad at you because I had a conversation at a
He's
family.
He's not great.
Name,
but for
what I'm
he
saying
do,
is,
complimentary
for next year. I think they'll get over like the first round, and that'll be about it.
Oh, see, now you tripping. Yeah, you just being controversial right now. Yeah,
you
yeah, you just trying to be controversial. Yeah, man.
So you think they're gonna contend to be champions?
I'm listening. Yes. I'm gonna put it to you like this. And I know we come on here to debate, but when it comes to sports, I think I'm debate out. Dealing with your family, I'm definitely debate out because your family been bugging. Your family been bugging lately over some shit. I gotta say, no, y'all been tripping.
Yo, well, don't take it out. This is what I'm getting out of
here. Yeah, y'all be tripping.
He taking it out on me.
Trace, you was there.
You know I'm not
basketball. I'm not debating.
I saw you text. I saw the Facebook text.
Oh, my God.
You said Malik Wayans was there?
Malik Wayans, Reggie.
And your cousin, Todd, they was tripping. No. Yo, I was surprised at Todd.
He named names. I'm saying.
Yo, they was bugging.
They said bugging. Al Horford is better than Karl Malone.
When they said that shit, that's why I can't do it. So I'm not even debating basketball with y'all. Yeah. Like,
better than Karl Malone.
Yeah,
he said it.
He's not even on the radar.
The thing was, it was when Todd said it, because he our area, and he was like, I said, what? And then he said Scottie Pippen was trash, and Paul George is better than Scottie Pippen. I couldn't take it no more.
At best would be Andre Iguodala.
And y'all ain't pull your phones out?
Yeah.
No, because I couldn't do it.
That
couldn't
don't
do
mean
it.
Nothing to them, though.
Yeah, I couldn't
do it. I'm just saying, exploit.
Yeah, I couldn't do it. So when it comes to your family right now, I ain't just speaking sports, man. I keep my mouth shut. Because y'all, that shit had me tripping.
Yeah, they was bugging.
So you saying what you saying? It don't surprise me at all.
I just think that he can do it with Paul George.
When they started talking about Isaiah.
Oh, they was killing Isaiah Thomas, dog.
They was killing Isaiah.
They said he was trash.
Went crazy.
They said Isaiah Thomas was like,
yeah.
They was killing your man.
Isaiah is almost on Mount Rushmore.
They said Drew Holiday was better than Isaiah Thomas.
Yo, listen, man.
I would have called the nurse, say, yeah. Can you please come over and check these niggas pee?
That's
if they pee dirty, I ain't even talking to y'all no more.
Yo, that's when it come when you like, yeah, we family, but then you got to say, no, that was your family. that was your family.
Yeah.
Drew Holiday?
Yeah, they was tripping, yo. Yeah.
Milk Dud? He haven't even scratched the surface.
You ain't got all yours. You ain't got to say it to me, man. You ain't got to say it to me. I'm not. I don't talk sports around them no more. I know when it comes to sports, I don't talk it. I don't say nothing no more.
Yeah. Al Horford.
They used to tell me that Michael Jordan was trash. So that's how I knew.
Al Horford better than Moses Malone.
No, Karl Malone.
Karl Malone.
The greatest. I don't even talk about it, man. I'm not even going to do it.
Yo. No moves, nothing.
They just was tripping, yo.
They said it was only powerful.
Don't bring it up, man. I ain't bringing it up, man.
All right, hold up. We gotta talk about Russell Westbrook.
We gotta keep it going.
That move was like awesome.
You think it's gonna work?
No,
I believe
it.
It might work. The love they have towards each other. It's not gonna be. They love each other.
No, they love each other because one was in OKC, and one was in Houston, and one was getting his money in Houston, and one was getting his money in OKC. One was getting his MVPs
in Houston. Basketball
man,
together.
That
since
was almost
was 10 like,
years ago, man.
No, they played in high school.
They didn't play in high school.
They from the same area,
but they ain't playing
in
high school.
They
played
together.
They didn't play together in high school.
I'm only saying what I heard.
I'm telling you what I know.
SportsCenter.
No, you ain't hear that from SportsCenter.
Wow.
I gotta tell you, cause y'all be tripping, yo, cause y'all just be saying shit, man. They did not play together in high school, man. Like, they didn't play together in high school.
Your phone on?
My phone
can
is
somebody
on.
Google it?
You can Google it.
Russell Westbrook, yeah. they didn't play until his junior year.
What
man.
I'm saying is, I'm not saying they played on the same team. They played against each other since they
were sixth grade. That ain't what you said. That ain't what you said. You said played together. That's not the same thing.
Okay, my bad.
Yeah. All right.
They played with each other. They love each other. What I'm hearing is they got a good relationship.
But I heard Chris Paul. Chris Paul and James Harden was cool before he came. I heard the same thing. And then what happened?
No love in basketball. Is that the line?
He got him out of there. They was ready to fight and everything. Like, so, I mean, yeah, you can love each other until you got to play with somebody, and then they don't, you know.
What I'm saying is the beard man had to request this young man, you know, and he know all the rumors. He know how Russ plays.
Well, he requested Chris Paul, too. I'm just saying, you know.
Well, we're going to see what happens.
Now, what about Chris Paul, though? What's going to happen with him, man?
Nothing. He's going to fade away.
I don't think so. I think he's going to find his way on the Lakers.
I
think he's going to find his way to the Lakers.
Looking at keeping him now.
Not July, but February.
I did think what you said.
February.
First.
It's not over. It's but the whole thing is.
Him and Ron doing the same team. That's going to be crazy.
Yeah, what I'm saying is they don't need him. They don't need him.
They don't need who?
Chris Paul.
No, you get Chris Paul. You all right.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is I heard that. What's that light skin boy?
They don't need him.
I think they need him better than Ron, though. I think they need Chris Paul more than they need Rondo.
We're going to see in February.
Chris Paul can still shoot the ball.
February.
That's when
the trade deadline.
After the All-Star, when they start. Well, hopefully everybody be healthy and LeBron James. You know what, man? For the first time in NBA history, we got a player and what is his friend called? Rich Paul?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know, that's LeBron's.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And the thing, that's crazy, ain't it?
No, it is crazy. Yeah, you got a player. You got a player agent. A player agent, man.
Right.
Ron is a player agent.
Black.
It was black.
So that's
he
that's
broke
crazy.
His own deals.
Yeah.
He his own worldwide.
What you think about Jay pulling that move?
Did Jay pull that move?
You ain't see him? Did you see him?
No.
Did you see Hov when Kyrie was signing that joint? Who's standing there with the Planes hat?
That was a Rock Nation joint.
That's
what I'm saying, though.
Who owned Rock Nation?
He don't own the Nets no more, right?
No, but I think he owned the building. He still owned part of the building.
Yeah. Why did he have to sell it? Because it was conflict of. Because
he owns a sports agency.
He owns a sports agency.
You can't own a team and have a sports agency.
Do you think they're going to block what LeBron James doing for the future? What you mean?
It's
really sneaky.
What you mean for the future, though? Like, I'm trying.
Like, nobody will be able to do this no more.
Well, no.
Like, put his best friend as the front man.
They can't do nothing about that.
They can't do nothing about that.
That's like crazy.
They can't do nothing about that, though.
Yeah.
But no, Jay, though, making it. That's, you know, Jay.
I'm with Jay. Yeah. I'm riding with Jay.
I like how he did that. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Well, speaking of Jay, he a billionaire now. How you feel? Allegedly, yeah.
You got a lot of people coming saying.
But how's it alleged if the Forbes showed his earnings?
I mean, they did the same thing with Dr. Dre, and then it wasn't a full billion.
Yeah.
No, but what happened with Dr. Dre was he spoke too soon. It was a billion.
It wasn't him. You know who it was.
Yeah, it was Tyrese.
Tyrese running his mouth.
No, so it didn't.
He the one who ran his mouth.
Because Forbes showed the. Because
it was like 940.
Yeah, because Forbes showed like the earnings list.
The acquisition and all that. Yeah.
Dr. Dre just whatever happened is that he was gonna be a billionaire with the Apple deal, but it just didn't happen that way. You know what I mean?
I don't think he will be solely a billionaire. They had to divvy that up with a few people. I mean, the deal was worth a billion dollars. No,
with
the beats.
Dre.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah.
So it wasn't like he was getting a billion, you know what's crazy?
It wasn't no publication that said Dr. Dre was. Everybody just said
it was all him.
It was everybody.
The billionaire hype.
Yeah, that video.
But Jay, I think that's a real billion.
Assets.
Yeah.
What's going to your assets? Yeah.
Amazing.
Yeah.
To me, he was a billionaire anyway. You know what I mean? Ain't nothing he could have did that make me look, just because I still look at him as the same. Amazing choices. Like, how smart can you be to put yourself in positions like that? Like, if you go a little bit left, you can blow, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And even after the Un situation, he still, you know.
It's so many things that could have went left for him that didn't. Right. Yeah, that didn't.
Well, that lets you know that, when they say that though, man, don't people have a 10-year plan? Right. And so, like, when people around you and they get mad at what happened year two or year mm-hmm. three, and he looking at it like, you can be mad all you want. I still got 7-8 more years to go in my plan.
I remember they tried to do it with Tidal, like when he bought Tidal, because Tidal was an overseas company.
Yeah.
And then it was like, when they was billing people, it was like an overseas company billing them, and they like, no, like, I don't want this, like, I ain't with that, like, yeah, because
who
like,
you?
Yeah, who you?
That's
like,
black folk,
yeah, like, they tried to come at him.
But I don't know, but right, but
New York
exactly.
Area code.
My title joint always said Tidal. I ain't know where
it
came from.
When it first started, like, when he first started it, it was a European company. And it was a European.
Well, I know it was a European company, but then he had bought that, right?
Yeah.
Then he had bought it.
I don't understand
why. I had
Tidal
from the beginning. I never seen
Puma must be paying him like crazy.
No, they is.
Because I want a pair of
sneakers. It's probably a partnership.
I want a paper plane sneaker so damn bad that I'm ready to make it.
You already know that's going to come, man.
I can't wait.
Well, no, it's going to come. If it's a dude that worked with Emery, he had some like 444 joints and everything. Like, they had them out,
but was that the 444 joints for like the album joint? But we talking about the like the paper planes.
Right on the side,
I mean,
like Chucks.
They had the paper planes on them though.
Right on
the
side. Shut our mouth. We don't want them to. You know what I mean? But I want them bad, man. Like I don't want to wear no Pumas, for real. You know? I feel as though like you know, Jay-Z control cool. He control what's cool, what's not. And my thing is, Why you like they gotta be paying him $300 million.
I think what he doing with Puma is he putting the young boys onto it. Like the Meeks.
He can put us onto the paper plane on the side of all.
No, but I'm talking about as far as like he's not trying to stop them from getting their money. You know what I'm saying? Like they don't, my thing is, you know, like Meek Mill, Nipsey and them had their own it's like other young boys that I think he divvying that with them, like, all right, y'all giving me this.
Yeah,
put these young boys on like that.
Hopefully he get that paper plane.
Remember he had the Puma plane for the tour.
They got a lot of them.
Like they had everything.
They be looking out for people.
Right.
I'm ready for my paper plane sneakers, bro.
Right.
Let's get it.
R. Kelly locked up again. Will this be for good this time now that his team turned over 20 tapes?
It's going to be another woman that's going to bail him out. Like, that's all it's going to be.
You think it's going to be a bailout situation
this
time?
High.
I mean, I don't know. It's gonna be, I'm just saying, like, I don't know if he's going
to
be.
I don't think you're going to be able to bail him out this time.
20?
That's crazy.
That's a lot of evidence.
That's a sick man.
Yeah, that's sick.
That's a sick man when you can't have no control of, you know?
Yeah.
How sick is the people that waited this long to hand that tape over?
They might be even sicker.
They is sicker, man.
and they being the manager.
Right.
Because they waited till now because now he ain't got no money.
They put charges on him.
Because
he knew
that
he was sleeping with.
Because I look at it like this. Like, if you going to do an act because you not financially benefiting from no more, that don't make you good now because you feel like in your heart, oh, I got to turn this over. It's been, what, almost 30-some years. And now you feel like in your heart, oh, because the money ain't coming in the same, that now I can do this. Nah. I blame all of them, man. Y'all, because y'all was, they was coercing that whole situation, man.
Yeah, I do.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
It's sad. All he had to do, the man came on BET, apologized. He had a preacher right beside him. And then you go right back the next year with your arrogant BS.
Right.
You know what I mean? Yeah. Still singing, like, you didn't fall back or none. So he deserved, you know, he deserved everything he get.
Yeah, he do.
And it's sad because that's my playlist. You feel me?
He got joints, man.
Yeah, he do.
Yeah.
I mean, he an all-time great.
And he don't own none of it.
He an all-time great.
Yeah.
He don't own none of his masters. He don't own none of his songs. You know, because he was balling.
It is sad, man.
Yeah, well, you want a loan? Yeah, just sign this paper. And he was like, they knew I couldn't read or write. You understand what I'm saying? And they took advantage of him. But I guess.
I mean, like, karma comes back.
Yeah.
It was coming back to him. You was doing wrong anyway. You know what I mean? So
That's what I'm saying. A lot of people be wanting to be celebrities and they be wanting to make it big. Yo, yeah. That stuff is like,
it's
you
a
know,
drug, man.
Yeah, it's like a lot of evil come behind that, you know?
Yeah, and his crazy. Sickness, I think, come from even before he got famous. Like, his upbringing was sick.
Yeah, they said like his sister was
yeah,
his
sister.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Yeah, that's...
That's crazy, man. Yeah. You know, may God bless him, and hopefully, you know, he can...
I just want to see more people get locked up behind that, though.
Yeah, well, his manager, the boy...
Well, not just his manager, though,
you know,
but, like...
talking to him on tape, confessing, basically. They're going to use that against him.
Like, I don't want to...
That Lifetime story thing. They're going to use all he was saying. I knew it, but, you know, he a grown man. Okay.
I don't want to... I don't want to... put the blame on, like, take the blame away from him, because he definitely deserved everything he get. But people that knew, though, they need to be held accountable too, yo. Because I just don't like how now you all of a sudden it's 20 tapes. Like, why now? It should have been when it happened the first time when Sparkle had put that shit out there. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Special news alert. I forgot about this.
Okay,
Nick Cannon. Mm-hmm. When he start talking about Jay-Z with Dash.
Yeah.
Oh, with Dame Dash and he broke out. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I'm sitting in my living room chilling, me and my wife, you know what I mean? God, smoking a cigar. You know what I mean? No, real talk. Next thing you know, Rock Boys came on. And Mariah Carey was laying on the sofa like, when they was married. I said, oh, that's why this nigga mad.
But I said that the first time.
You did?
Yeah. Remember I said that? I said, it was Mariah Carey. I said,
rocking out with it. She was on.
I would have been mad.
She was one of them.
My wife ain't going to be in no Jay-Z video as no damn feature.
She was in a couple niggas' videos, man.
No, but what I'm saying, this John, why he was married to her. I said, this is where the hate come from. Yeah. You know what I mean? And I'm watching.
You know that,
man. I'm watching, like, old clips, and I see Jigga Man and Aaliyah like cozy.
But we
like,
do that.
Well, yeah,
but
what I'm
we talked about that though.
That's why. That's why they ain't like this. What caused the whole riff of this thing?
That's why if you look at it, Dame Dash was like, "Say what you want to say." He was like, "Say what you want to say." He's like, "You want to say something? Say what you want."
Y'all
like,
ever
no,
see?
I did say what I want to say.
What about the song "You like, Must you Love Me"? Say. He was like, "You know, we all boys. We all getting money and." No matter how pretty she is, we never liking your girl.
No. I do y'all one better. Y'all ever see Death of a Dynasty?
Yeah.
What was it about?
It was about nothing.
No.
It was weak.
No, it was about something.
What you mean?
Hold on. Y'all ain't get it was about them and Aaliyah.
Oh no, wow. I didn't get that.
Well, I gotta watch it again.
I gotta watch it again.
It was so.
I gotta watch it again.
No, the actors was so poor. Yeah, I watched it because I had Rockefeller on there.
No, the reason why I was poor like that is because they was trying to make fun of the situation, but it was too many truths in it.
Yeah. Uh huh.
Look at the Exotic Drone.
I'm gonna
watch it again. The Exotic Drone.
I can't do it.
Look, the Exotic Drone was who first?
I can't watch none of his movies.
No, I'm saying though, Death of Dynasty, the Exotic Drone was who first?
Mm-hmm.
Jay Z, right?
Yeah.
That's Aaliyah. And then she ended up going with Dame Dash in the movie.
Yeah.
And then it was the split. And then remember they had the two separate
label
drones.
Separate labels.
And then
the death of
and then at the end of the movie, what they
got
say?
At the end of the movie,
remember they all came out? It was Biggs and a Jay.
Uh-huh.
And Dame Dash, Jay wasn't really saying nothing, but he was like, if y'all ever thought that we was going to break up over a female. See, y'all probably don't remember the movie, but watch Death of a Dynasty.
Yeah, I gotta watch
it
again.
I guarantee if you watch it again, you're gonna be like, yo, this shit is crazy. Like, they told, listen,
check it out.
They broke down the breakup.
And you know what I think? I think when Jay start acting funny, every time he start acting funny, now Dame Dash know that this nigga got like 8 girls. He can't tame all of them, so I'm gonna get this nigga treat me like this. This is how I'm gonna get
him back. No,
watch. You know what I mean?
No, listen.
I'm gonna get with some of his
jokes.
Why
Death of a Dynasty? Because he keeps saying it. Just sleep with their girl.
Listen.
You ever see his interviews?
Death of a
Dynasty. I just take their girl. That's all he say.
But watch it though.
Take their girl. He talking about.
Yeah.
Watch Death of a Dynasty again. Watch it tonight. When you see it, I'm saying it's really the breakup.
Man, no disrespect.
Well, it's called Death of a Dynasty.
Dame got so much potential. I watched Poseidon and his movies.
Yeah.
I'm like, this is horrible.
The Woodsman, all of them. They all horrible. I never, the one he not always
saw. He got the y'all niggas crazy look.
No, I'm listening agree? To their movies. Yeah, I don't like.
Oh my God.
I don't like his. Like,
I was so disappointed. Was,
State Property 2 was like the, was one of the worst movies.
Now,
it was acceptable.
Cameron.
It's trash.
What's the name of that one?
With Mook in there?
Yeah.
No, that's called like some. It's like a Spanish name.
Honor
but
up.
He got another
honor
one with some Spanish name, though. Got the locks in it, too.
I'm talking about Honor Up.
And all that pointing at throwing jabs at Jay-Z, saying he not honorable for doing what he doing.
But you know when you keep saying that about somebody, crazy. You really talking about yourself.
Oh, man.
Because he ain't honorable when you start doing what he was doing, but you know.
Yeah, but I just wanted to point that out now. Yeah. I know why Nick Cannon was really mad.
We reached the midpoint. This week's on Bobby's World.
I ain't do nothing.
You did some stuff.
For real?
You did some stuff.
I fell back.
When you walked up on that Puerto Rican girl and that white boy, and you asked, are you okay?
Oh,
are you
that was like a month old. Yeah. How we doing? We good? Yeah, that was a month old.
I can't tell the time on here.
All of them be parking where I park, so it was like it's a perfect time to prank somebody. He was mad. He was, I ain't even put the full video up.
He was heated.
Yep.
He was heated.
Pissed.
Yeah, he was heated. She was like, we're okay.
Yep, he was pissed.
Yeah, you had some stuff going on.
I just don't
on,
like
though.
When you put videos up and the people in the comments, the followers, they just remind you of piranhas. When they see blood and they twist it all to, oh, about time the white man know what it feel like for somebody to run up on. Like, y'all niggas, wild.
Yeah.
They may not even be happy that it's a prank. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Yeah. No, they be.
Like, it's crazy.
People be going crazy.
I think a lot of it was his reaction, too. If he wouldn't have reacted the way he,
it was,
like,
that ain't
he,
even
he
the whole
reacted
video.
Like, the hell you doing walking up on me, questioning me? Like, he had... Yeah,
the water department boy. It was the water department boy I got Saturday. I was like, can you do me a favor? Close your mouth. Hold up. You running up on me and you directing me? I was like, you know why I do y'all, right? You're like, why? I said, because y'all can't hit me. Y'all jokers make $22,000.
Yeah, that's smart.
Yo, Buck, you crazy, yo.
I just try to, I've been through a lot, and a lot of times, honestly, I try to escape the real world and just try to laugh stuff away. You know what I mean? This world crazy, man.
Yeah, it is.
Y'all watch the BET Awards?
BET Awards.
Did y'all watch it?
Yeah, I watched it.
Mary J. Blige.
Oh, that shit was all that.
Loved it.
That shit was all
loved
that.
Loved it. She.
Mary killed it.
Oh, I
Mary
wanted to get Ken do the middle finger. I caught myself.
Yeah, Mary killed it.
Yeah, Mary killed it. Loved it. What else?
I like Method Man.
Yeah, Method Man coming out was
Meth
cool.
Was hype when he was leaving the stage. He was like, because
he
knew
they really killed it. They really killed it. I love what they did.
Yeah, hopefully we can see a lot more of our. He already warned me of our old times. Ain't nothing like it. We got a lot of stuff that we can't relate to. Nipsey Hussle tribute. I did not know that was a song.
What, the higher joint?
Yeah. When that was my first time seeing it. I'm thinking that was just a tribute for him.
No.
And I was, let me tell you something, man. The bull was on to something. And it's a shame that his death took all of, for me, to realize how hot he was. I was devastated because... that 10-year plan that you talked about earlier. Yeah. Like, he was honestly on it's like Tupac Shakur lit something in that young man's soul because he had that, he was way ahead of his time. And his lyrics was like.
I mean,
I didn't know.
Yeah. A lot of people didn't know.
I was late to the party.
Can I ask you a question?
Yeah.
Why you keep looking at your watch, bro? You love your Apple Watch?
I was late to the party.
Oh, he ignored me. Yeah. Oh, I forgot they get Texas and stuff.
So that's all we talking about on the BET Award.
I'm on my way. No. The tribute. Lauren London came through. The sister came through. His grandmother came through. But the mom, The mom kind of like made me backslide, and the, like it's like that. She dragging me right back to.
But she did it at his funeral. So why would you think she would do something else? She did it at his funeral. She was talking crazy then too.
Yeah, everything she said makes sense. But I was like, man, it was sort of like, you know, and nobody ain't going to say nothing.
Yeah,
she got more.
She's mourning, yo.
It's a mother with a connection with her son. Yeah, that's all I look at.
Yeah, she mourning.
She got a connection, a different connection with her son. Than we do. Yeah. Like, we like his music. His, she got a different connection
yeah.
with him.
Yeah, I understand. She but morning, I just, I mean, think, I just thought that it was like, what? Like, she sucked the life. She sucked.
You know, some people just don't know. She's not a public speaker. Well, and then she's not a public speaker. Like, she. Everybody can't just get in front of 20, 50,000 people and then just say, you know what I mean?
So remember when she told the story about the video inside the gas station, and he was like, sir, this and that. She like she just
she believed
like
her son
she
was.
She believes it.
She believed her son was murdered, not murdered, but what they call it?
Assassinated.
Assassinated.
She also
and
believed
cops,
that he seen it coming, that he knew
and
it
the cops
coming.
Had something to do with it. I heard that he got $75,000, but that's alleged. It's hearsay. The boy got $75,000.
What boy? The
yeah, that's what some people saying. You know,
but for what though?
On the worldwide dark web, because it's 10-year plan. Like if you can get Mike to begin to start talking about, let us start talking about Black Power, and we get 100,000 followers.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's a problem.
Yeah,
you'll never hear Jay-Z.
I already told you that's
saying,
power
to the people.
That's
ever.
In the Constitution. Ever. There you go. We had a president. Say like that was the greatest threat to American civilization was the rise of the Black Negro. So you already know that ain't going nowhere. We live in a white supremacist world anyway.
Right.
So you already know.
Yeah. It's crazy.
All right. JD comments about women rappers. Agree or disagree?
I mean, I agree with him. I agree with him more because I don't think he talking about more the mainstream and the majority because he know about the Rhapsody, Sierra Wack and all them.
Mm-hmm.
But I just named two. But if I name the next 10 rappers, they all on that type time. It's
on the
either,
forefront city.
Yeah,
girls,
it's all about, you know, like he said, it's they strippers.
Music.
They stripping music. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Is and they putting themselves out there as strippers and as this is all we want to do.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? All he's saying is he just want to be a mix, a variety of music. Like we can have that, but we gotta start putting.
Well, don't you think he could help control that though? He could grab some of these. He
yeah, but
grab
the thing
some
is,
but how can he help?
He too old to be
yeah,
molding
that's what
somebody.
I'm saying
no, I'll do it like that's.
You
like,
think they need molding? They just need the opportunity.
You only can put out what you have in you. You understand? They don't got
but
the
I don't
Queen
know,
Latifah bars.
I don't know if it's.
You ever heard Tierra Whack?
No, it's women out
her
there.
Her last name turned me off.
No, but she ain't whack though. But
she ain't
whack though.
Is that the girl that Snoop just put on this morning?
Yeah, yeah I guess. Yeah.
I don't know. You talking about Rhapsody? You ever Rhapsody?
You talking about T.I.? When T.I. put it up, Snoop may have. I didn't see Snoop's. But
she
T.I.
had
put
hat
it
on. And
yes.
Oh my God.
Listen.
You think she whack?
No.
That's what I'm saying. Like, and Rhapsody probably the best. Rhapsody can go there as one of the best rappers in the game.
That goes back to the what you say about the most threat to the United States is
yeah the rise mm-hmm. of yeah so you imagine
so
a woman
they not oh, gonna man. Give they not gonna put invest in music that's building us up
mm-hmm.
they want this trash stripper stuff out
see I think
because it makes money
it I think
make
we see
money.
Like,
it makes money and it also teach a nation
but
of
to his
young
comment,
girls that this yeah. is all right
but
the
Trace comment though when he was like JD you think he can. I think just because he's JD, I don't think at this point in time he can just do that. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like, I could just put somebody in position because that takes, you know what I mean? He's still, yeah, he's JD, but that don't mean he JD 10 years ago. You know what I mean? Like, because he had the brat.
You still need back.
Yeah, because remember, he was
you need a machine
he was behind bringing the brat. You know what I'm saying? And the brat wasn't on that type time. You know what I mean? She was on the type time that he was talking about.
What
like,
the fellas doing out here? What is the number one besides Kendrick and J. Cole special? What are the other young boys giving us?
Right.
Bullcrap. Bullcrap yeah. because right. this stuff. Is another way. This is the way, only way that they can give you a deal. They ain't going to give you a deal educating us.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? And mm-hmm. it's sad. That's the
It
real,
was just good that he spoke
story.
On it, though, because it might seem controversial, but, I mean, it's the truth, though.
Yeah. Like, it's like.
Because it's. But I don't see it no different than when Lil' Kim and Foxy was coming up. That's what was getting the most attention.
What right. I'm saying is they showed sexiness, but they right. bars was
no. When I mean, yeah, they yeah, had, yeah, yeah, but they no, rap. But they had they bars. But I'm talking about, but they message they so, was almost still the same though. They message was still
what
the
you
same.
Mean? You can get this Gucci in the morning, daytime, shake that ass on you, feel it like a bullet, come on, push yeah, it that. Down. No, it wasn't like
no,
that.
I'm not rapping Lil' Kim lyrics. So what I'm saying not gonna is, do it. I'm just saying though, what I'm just saying
it
though.
It wasn't like
Lil'
today.
Kim got
all
some
they,
lyrics, like you should talk about.
Oh, man.
She wasn't talking, Lil' Kim wasn't talking with Queen Latifah and Moni Love and them was talking about. That's what I'm saying. So,
God, it wasn't nothing. These look, yo, I can't get her lyrics together.
You getting court? No, you getting
they
court
weren't
on,
conscious.
The, on the con? You getting court on they, me on the? What I'm saying is, I'm not talking about the rap style or the lyrics. What I'm saying is the message of the music was kind of
sort of
they paved the way for this.
Uh huh.
You know what I'm saying? That's what I'm saying. Like Lil Kim had a billboard of what? You remember the bill? That's what I'm saying. Like,
it was in a lot of rooms.
Yeah, word. So you feel what I'm saying? So that's what I'm saying. Like, I ain't talking about, like, yeah, they can rap back then. I'm just talking about the message of the music was still, like, we here only to get money and blah, blah, blah. I'm not going to rap Lil' Kim lyrics. You know what I mean? Like, it's not the same as rapping, like, a Queen Latifah. You not T.Y. It's not, you know what I mean? Yeah, I can rap
I
you and not T.Y., but I can't rap a Lil' Kim song.
I got you. That's what I mean. So the lyrics nowadays is just so dumb and simple. You know
well,
what
yeah,
I mean?
It is simple,
so man. I understand what you're saying.